hallelujah, hallelujah, this morning, the Most High. We get up to say Shema, Israel, Adonai, Eloheinu, Adonai, Akkad. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Blessed be the name of his glorious kingdom forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah. And bless your name. High God and all his righteousness, knowing that all things shall be added unto us. Therefore, we come seeking, knocking, and asking on day six as the sun gets ready to set this evening. We're gonna enter into his sweet Sabbath rest. Come on now, we're going to rest in the Most High God. See, we done toiled all week long. And I'm so glad when the Most High God created the world from the beginning, he had a day of rest. And he rested from all that he had done. So we're going to enter in to his rest. Oh, Lord. It's nothing like the Sabbath. It's nothing like the Sabbath. Do you understand the Sabbath is the Most High God? You as his bride wearing your ring. It's the signet ring. That's how the world knows that you're set apart is by his Sabbath day. That's how the world knows that you didn't take the mark of the beast. It's by his Sabbath day. That's how the world knows that you are in this world, but you're not of this world because you serve the Most High God a separation. Mm-hmm. Oh, he's separating the wheat from the tares, the sheep from the goat, the clean from the unclean. The holy from the unholy. You better know what kind of Most High God we serve. When he took the children out of Egypt and took them into the wilderness, it was about a separation. It was about separating them from 365 gods. Because see, they could worship any god that they decided to worship. They had a god for every day of the week. The Most High God is the one and only God. He is a God. He is the one and only God that can give you rest like never before. Mm-hmm. Because he gives peace that surpasses all understanding. While the world is walking in fear and going crazy with the coronavirus, he gives us peace. Yeah. I'm talking about Shabbat Shalom on the Sabbath that surpasses all understanding. You want to know why? Because we have been taught by the word, lean not to our own understanding, but in all our ways acknowledge the Most High. And see, we're acknowledging right now that this is his time, counting up the Omer, counting up to Shavuot. This is his time to be still and know that he is the Most High God, because we are in the wilderness and he's given us his commandments. All we got to do is be willing and obedient. Yeah. We don't even have to guess where we are right now. We don't even have to guess what's going on in our lives. We know exactly what time it is. Mm-hmm. And we know that we are in the right place at the right time, because the Most High God is the Most High God of knowledge, understanding, and wisdom. And let me tell you one thing. He will no longer have us ignorant of Hasatan devices. Come on now. Because his people have been destroyed from lack of knowledge. Yeah. You haven't got the knowledge that you need. And knowledge is information. See, you got the wrong information. You got the commandments of men. You got the dogmas of men. You got the teachings of men. You got the doctrine of men. You better know right now. You better let the Most High God be true and every man a liar. Yeah. I'm talking every man. You know, we kind of pick and choose. Okay, they might have a little bit of the truth. Oh, they doing all this, but they just ain't doing this one piece. You know, you can't be going after folks that got a piece of the truth. The Most High God said, ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Mm-hmm. So let's enter into his rest today. Mm-hmm. That's what we need to do. I'm so excited. I've been ready for day 6. I don't know about nobody else. It's been a long week. I was saying to my son the other day, don't you think this has been a long week? He was like, no, not really. It's already Wednesday. No. That would be day 4, but it's still a long week to me. Yes, it has been a long week, and I'm ready to enter into his rest. Anybody else ready to enter into his rest? Because he gives that peace. Mm-hmm. I mean, come on, the shalom that he gets when you know you're in the Sabbath. Mm-hmm. There's no toiling and turning and, oh, Lord, I don't want to get up. I know I ain't want to get up on Sunday morning. I know why now. I just did not want to get up on Sunday morning. I was like, But since I crossed over, and we know the cross. cross over means Hebrew. Since I crossed over Hebraically, honey. Oh, Lord. Saturday. Well, first of all, let's start that party on Friday night. Mm-hmm. Friday night at sunset, I'll be like, well, the weekend.
Yeah.
Yes. I get to enter into his rest. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Most High God. The whole atmosphere changes at sunset. You know what I'm saying? You be like, woo, okay, let's go. You know, you get some energy from somewhere. All week long, you kind of been dragging that wagon. You know, just dragging. But you know, when that 6 day comes, you be like, oh, when the sun set tonight. Because I'm in relationship with him. I get to meet him. He has appointed times. He shows up on Sabbath.
Yeah.
I guess I was tossing and turning because on Sunday he wasn't going to be there. So I needed the choir to fill me up. Go on, sing that song now. Go on, sing it. Woo, Lord. They'd be like, what was the message today? I don't know, girl, but the choir showed out. Child, they shouted everywhere. Mm. Child, they was up there in that choir stand getting down. So now that I enter into his rest, and I know I have an appointment with him, and I'm in relationship, everything in my life has changed. Mm-hmm. Oh, my goodness. You know how you be serving the wrong God and you didn't know? Now you know, oh my goodness, this is the one and only Most High God. He is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And I'm in the right place at the right time. And I'm excited about it because I know now, I know that he's a rewarder to them that diligently seek him. Mm-hmm. You can't stop seeking him now in this wilderness. Things happen in the wilderness. It's supposed to happen because he's testing you. He said, I took the children of Israel out into the wilderness to test them, to see whether they would keep my commandments or no. Yeah. So it doesn't matter with situations in life. We have to know we have to keep on walking with the Most High God because we walk by faith and not by sight. We ain't looking at what we see. Because, you know, faith is an action word. Mm-hmm. We keep moving in the way of the Most High God. We know him to be a cloud by day and a fire by night. We know him. I mean, look, the children of Israel, I can say it over and over again, because since this coronavirus and it's been, you know, shelter in place, now it's safer at home. Their shoes and clothes never wore out. He kept sickness and diseases away from them. He said, so as the serpent is lifted up in the wilderness, so shall the Son of Man be. Come on now. You know you're in the right place.
Yes.
At the right time. So I'm thankful to enter into his rest, mm-hmm. not man's rest. If man had his way, child, you'd be working forever. Mm. We are entering into his rest.
Yes.
Good morning, beautiful one, Sister Evelyn Queen. Praying for your daughter, praying things are okay and that she's getting better. I've been praying without ceasing because I know the Most High God to be a healer. I'm sending Raphael to encamp around her bed, knowing right now that no weapon formed against her shall prosper, and even if a tongue shall rise up against her, she shall condemn it, because this is a decade of declaration, and we put healing in the atmosphere right now. We don't walk in fear, because the Most High God didn't give us a spirit of fear, but power and love and a sound mind. I'm telling you right now, he's a keeper, and he will keep sickness and diseases and everything else away from her, and I thank him in advance, because we know to bless the Lord at all times. Come on now. We know to bless the Lord at all times. And his praises will continually be in our mouths. Come on and magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. Because in unity is where he commands the blessing. I dare you to get on one accord. I believe the report of the Most High God. Hallelujah. In this wilderness, I know we can take them giants. Come on, Joshua and Caleb. We are in the wilderness. Come on, and I believe the report of the Most High God. Thank you, Most High. Uh-huh. So come on and enter into his rest. Lay aside every weight that so easily beset you, and cast your cares on the Most High God, because he cares for you. You better come on and enter into his rest.
Yeah.
Oh, Lord. I'm thankful right now. I'm thankful. Because if it had not been for the Most High God that was on my side, where would I be? I thank him right now because he's a shield and a buckler. Come on now. He's a shelter in a time of storm. He's the only one that can speak to the winds and the waves in your life and say, peace. Be still. Oh, Lord. He's the only one that can bid you to come out on the water. Wow. Sometimes you got to come out in those deep waters because the Most High God is calling you higher. He said, come on up a little bit higher. Yeah. So I'm thankful right now that the Most High God is keeping us like never before. I don't care what the world is going through. I don't care what the world is saying. The Most High God is keeping us. Uh-huh. In this wilderness like never before. It's always what you don't know. Come on in here, Queen Lisa Brimmett. You got me on fire the other day when you made that post and you said, some of y'all that have been in the pandemic, y'all gonna come out of this pandemic better than when you went in. And I had to begin to bless him because I knew for myself that the Most High God has kept me. I knew for myself I ain't been sick during this pandemic. I knew for myself that he has opened up the windows of heaven and he continues to pour me out a blessing that I don't have room to receive. I knew for myself that he's keeping my children. I knew for myself that the Most High God is actually a healer in a time like this. When the world coronavirus is running rapid, the Most High God is still keeping me. Mm-hmm. Girl, don't you post nothing like that again. You got me on fire. I begin to think about, come on, Queen. I begin to think about. And sometimes you just got to sit down and you got to think about the things that the Most High God has done for you. Uh-huh. I begin to think about the goodness of the Lord. Uh-huh. I can hear David right now talking to me. Oh, Lord, I would have fainted if I had not believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living.
Yeah.
So I begin to think about the goodness of the Lord and all that he's done for me.
Yeah.
And my soul begin to cry holy. Uh-huh. My soul begin to bless his name.
Yeah.
Oh, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Because he has done great things for me. I don't know about you, but he has done great things for me.
Yeah.
Kept me. In the midst of it all.
Ah.
Oh, I'm in this wilderness. Mm-hmm. I'm counting up the Omer as I count on the Most High God. Because he's the only one that you can count on.
Yeah.
He'll sit you down by yourself and tell you, you can count on me.
Glory.
Don't you stop counting. Don't you stop counting. So, sister, I'm telling you right now, beautiful woman of God, you set my soul on fire with that post. I was like, I could just stay here all day in these comments because the Most High God. How much time you have to, so I can let you know how the Most High God has blessed me during this pandemic? I mean, come on now. I can go all the way into next year. Because he goes before me. It makes every crooked place straight.
Yeah.
I just been thinking about that. He goes before me and makes every crooked place straight. Thank you, Most High God. You want to know why? Because he is the way, the truth, and the life. I'm so thankful right now. And I'm so thankful right now. Oh, my goodness. I think about my family. I think about, you know, nobody in my family has coronavirus. You know, my family is not struggling through this pandemic. They haven't missed a meal or a bill.
Yes.
That's what I'm thinking about. And the ones that are out there because they're considered essential workers, like King Reynard, he keeps showing up. So I know the Most High God has placed a head of protection around you, King Reynard. He has placed a hedge around you. So when I see my family is still standing. And I ain't talking about just my birth family. I'm talking about 5 a.m. prayer family.
Yes.
When y'all come on, y'all don't know how excited I get because I know you're still standing.
Mm-hmm.
The Most High said, I placed a hedge around him.
Yeah.
You know, the enemy right now is inquiring about you. Oh, Most High, could you take that hedge down? I bet you I could get Ray Naughty if you take that hedge down. Oh, no, we ain't taking the hedge down. That's what we're not going to do. All right, Most High God. Most High God, come on now. The enemy is inquiring about you, Queen, woman of God. Come on now, Lisa. The enemy is saying, can you take that hedge down? Because I'm trying to get to her, but I can't get to her. And the Most High God is saying, no, you can't take the hedge down. That's what we're not going to do.
Yes.
He's your shield,
mm-hmm,
and your buckler.
Mm.
He's your shelter in a time of storm. Mm. Come on now. He's a healer. By his stripes, you are healed.
Mm-hmm.
We're walking in healing. We're walking in deliverance. We're walking out of lack. Ain't no lack. Ain't going to be no lack. Thank you, Most High God. With or without a stimulus. I'm telling you right now, because I've been looking for the stimulus. I ain't got it yet. But with or without a stimulus, he's still keeping us. Because he shall supply all our needs according to his riches and glory. I would rather for the Most High God to bless me than Trump. I'm just saying. It might be a return on that. I know I gave you that 1,200 stimulus, but I'm going to take that out of something.
Mm.
I'd rather for the Most High God to bless me as I'm counting up to Shavuot, to the great outpouring. I'm walking in expectation. Now, don't get me wrong. I'm still using wisdom. When it comes to this coronavirus, I'm still using wisdom. I don't care how much they opening this up a little bit and they opening that up a little bit and they doing a little bit of this and a little bit of that. I'm using the wisdom of the Most High God.
Yes.
When I walk out of my house, I'm still wearing a mask. I'm washing my hands 50 million times a day. That's what we do anyway. Our mama taught us to wash our hands. Come on now. We know to wash our hands.
Mm-hmm.
We ain't going out in these places and say, hey, I'm just going to go and hang out because, you know, I believe, it won't touch me. Huh?
Hmm.
We're using wisdom during this season of coronavirus.
Uh-huh.
Come on now. We ain't just being out there. We ain't, like, socializing with folks. I'm still social distancing. I kind of like the shelter in place, but I really like safer at home. Because that means we can't have no visitors right now. We ain't having no cookouts and no barbecues and all that stuff getting together. We being wise.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. A wise man builds his house on a solid foundation.
Uh-huh.
And we building our house on Yahushua. Come on now. The solid rock we stand, all of the ground is sinking sand. And I'm thankful that we're using wisdom in a season like this. Thank you, Most High. So to all the essential workers on 5 a.m. prayer that you have to go out every single day, I'm covering you in prayer.
Mm-hmm.
Don't think I'm not praying for you. I'm praying for you daily. Ever since you told me, King Raynard, that you have to go out. I've been praying for you daily. All essential workers, if you're essential, I got you. I'm praying for you. I might not lift you up by name, but the ones that I do know that's out there, and I know your name, I'm lifting you up by name. Because
mm-hmm.
the Most High God knows your name is graven in his hand.
Yeah.
So I'm thankful. I'm excited because I get to enter into his rest.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my goodness, he gave us brand new mercies and a brand new day. You know, I used to hear my mama say, you better praise him because somebody didn't get up this morning.
Mm-hmm.
Now with this coronavirus, somebody really did not get up this morning.
Mm-hmm.
The count is going higher and higher, but you got up this morning. He spared your life. He gave you another day. I'm talking about brand new mercies and a brand new day. Come on in here, April. You know he chose you, girl.
Mm-hmm.
Many are called, but few are chosen. Come on, April. Come on, girl. We know we just blessed the Most High God on yesterday. We blessed him and we were thankful because he gave us commandments. I'm just thankful and I'm just beginning to bless him for all that he's done. I mean, you look at your children, and none of your children are sick. You know, you look at these people that have to go into the hospital, you know, and they have to go in there by themselves.
Mm.
And you can't go visit them. And so that's heavy on a mother's heart. I understand. I really do. But he's a keeper.
Yes.
I don't care what nobody says. He is a keeper, and he is keeping us. Mm-hmm. And now we get to enter into his rest. Mm. It's nothing like entering into the Most High God's rest. Come on, April. I saw you, girl. You got that challah bread ready. Got it braided all up. Come on now. Where they get them braids from, April? How they know how to braid? Where that come from? Because we are the original cornrows. What you talking about? Why is it named challah bread? Holla at your girl, April. Come on, talk to me. You had that bread braided, baby. I was like, yes, we about to enter into his rest. Yes, we are. And I am thankful to have an understanding of scripture. Mm-hmm. 6 days, the Most High God created the heavens and the earth. And on the seventh day, he rested.
Yeah.
When you catch that revelation, oh Lord, and you realize that Saturday, Sabbath, is the holy day of rest for the Most High God, whoop, you wake up with a whole different attitude on Sabbath. You be like, oh Lord, he's sweet, I know. I be saying, my mom, you know, my mother's old hymn, he's sweet, I know. He's sweet, I know. Oh, yeah. He's sweet, I know. He's sweeter than honey in a honeycomb.
Yeah.
I love him. Because mm-hmm. he has given us rest. Yahushua said, my peace I leave with you. Mm-hmm. So if we would just lay aside every weight that so easily beset us, and cast our cares on him because he cares for us. Mm-hmm. We're resting that thing.
Yeah.
I'm so serious. If we would lay aside every weight. It's time to lay aside this week, y'all. I'm letting it go. Lay aside every weight mm-hmm. that so easily beset you.
My Lord.
We ain't in fear, y'all. We ain't in fear. He didn't give us a spirit of fear.
Yeah.
Every day something different is coming out about this coronavirus. We're not walking in fear. Fear is not in our DNA. He didn't give us a spirit of fear, but power and love and a sound mind.
Yeah.
So lay aside every weight that so easily beset you. Mm-hmm. And what you going to do after that? I'm going to cast my cares on the Most High because he cares for me. I'm going to cast them. Mm-hmm. So that's the way we got to walk through this coronavirus, y'all, because it's getting serious. With them reopening things slowly, because you know the world is crying. Are we tired of being shut up? We got rights. You know them people. Mm-hmm. The ones on Capitol Hill with guns and stuff that, you know, nothing gonna be done to them because they privileged, you know. Uh-huh, them. So they just want us to open up, not even knowing. But the Most High God said, you in the wilderness. Uh-huh. You are just like the children of Israel. You are in the wilderness.
Yeah.
Do y'all understand we're counting up to Shavuot?
Come on.
I know in the Christian world you call it Pentecost. But in Hebrew, Pentecost is the number of 50. And in Hebrew, it means Shavuot. Mm-hmm. So we're counting up to Shavuot. We're in the wilderness just like the children of Israel. He's that cloud by day and fire by night. We're only moving when he tells us to move. Come on now. We know right now where we are. So it's different for me walking through this coronavirus. Because I know I'm in the wilderness. And when they were in the wilderness, he said this to Moses. So as the serpent is lifted up, so shall the Son of Man be. And that serpent was the one, the medicine, that kept sickness and diseases away from the children of Israel. Mm-hmm. So I know during this time of coronavirus, the serpent is lifted up in the wilderness. That's where I'm at.
Yeah.
And the Most High God is keeping sickness and diseases away from us. Why do y'all think on every medical book they got that little serpent wrapped around a stick. Come on now. You can't add to the word, don't take away from it. I know they can twist it. But you better believe that's what that means. Healing. So I'm sending Raphael out to the nations to heal. And everyone that's on a ventilator today to just heal. Because the Most High God is the one who blew the very breath of life into man, and man became a living soul. So I ask the Most High God to walk through every hospital, ICU room today and just begin to breathe for them.
Yeah.
That they would need the ventilator. That he would breathe the very breath of life into every hospital around the globe. Oh, Lord. Oh, there's healing in his wings. And healing is the children's bread. So I'm calling for healing right now for everyone that is sick. I'm calling for healing right now. Heal, Most High God. Deliver. Be their comforter. Let them know that they are not alone. Even though the world is saying they're alone once they go in there, let them know they are not alone.
Yes.
That you will never leave them comfortless. That you will send the comforter and that you would breathe the very breath of life into them.
Yes.
So I thank you right now. As we get ready to enter into your rest, counting up the omer, I'm just thankful. I'm thankful to know where we are at this very moment. Y'all keep praying. The word says to pray without ceasing. The word says don't be anxious for nothing. We ain't anxious. Don't be anxious for nothing. But in all things, in prayer and supplication, making your petitions known before the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. It says some kind come by fasting and praying. So we don't want to stop praying. Keep on praying. Prayer is our petition. Do you understand prayer is legal? That's why it's called a petition. Prayer is our petition to the Most High God. So we're going to keep praying. We're going to keep praising him. We're going to keep blessing his name. We're going to keep telling the Most High God he's more than able. We're going to keep exhorting him. I'm just so excited that the Most High God is doing marvelous things.
Yes.
Because he is marvelous.
Mm-hmm.
Come on now. Excellent is his name in all the earth. Come on now. You got to begin to bless him because he's doing great things for you. He has done great things for you.
Mm-hmm.
He has done great things. You're here.
My Lord.
That's enough right there.
Mm-hmm.
You're still here. Thank you, Most High. Woo, Most High. I come lifting up everyone on Facebook Live this morning. I ask you right now to cover them and go with them everywhere that they go. Send your spirit of protection that you would protect them from every attack of the enemy. Make sure they walk in your knowledge, understanding, and wisdom. This is a season for them to be wise in. Have them to apply your commandments to their lives. Have them to separate themselves when they need to separate. Because you're calling for separation. Thank you for us being in the wilderness, counting up the omer, picking up manna every single day. Because we know that you are the bread that fell from heaven, Yahushua. And the word says that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of the Most High God. Your word does not return void, neither shall it be reversed. And it will do exactly what you sent it to do. You said heaven and earth shall pass away, but your word shall stand forever. I thank you right now that I can stand on your word. When the world is standing on answers from somebody else, we can stand on your word. We can seek you in your word and begin to understand the place that we are in, and we just need to enter into your rest today. Decrease me as you give the increase. I'm not sufficient of myself. All sufficiency lies on the inside of you. And I will forever give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. And it's in the mighty, mighty name of Yahushua, I pray. Amen, 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 and amen. All right, April. You need to know, and she done put it in the comments, the appointed times of prayer. 9, 12, and 3. Now, you can pray anytime you want to, but you better know that praying without ceasing, according to the Most High, according to the scriptures, is that you stop when it's 9 o'clock, whatever zone you in, and you begin to pray. You stop at noonday, no matter where you are. You ain't got to pray a long prayer. You just got to acknowledge the Most High God. And at 3, those are the appointed times of prayer. Everything the Most High God does, he does it by an appointment. So don't forget that. You pray at 9, 12, and 3. Hallelujah, and bless his name. He gave Abraham the 9 o'clock prayer. He gave Isaac the noonday prayer. And he gave Jacob, before he changed his name to Israel, the 3 o'clock prayer. You better come on and know what the scriptures are. You better know how the Most High God operates in his word.
Yeah.
He has appointments, appointed times, 9, 12, and 3. So all this time, woman of God, Lisa, you've been having your noonday prayer. That's the reason why, because you're praying on time, on point, and on target. That's all I got to say about that. All right. The word says, if two or three gather together in his name, that he would be in the midst. Show enough, show enough. I'm feeling the Holy Ghost this morning. Yeah. The word says, if two touch and agree on anything, it shall be done. And I know I can't do nothing this morning without this word being established through the law, the prophets, and the writings. Mm-hmm. So there's a method style to studying the word of the Most High God. And it's a process of studying the word of Ahaya, Asha, Ahaya, which is I am that I am in Hebrew. The great I am. The God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And we seek his guidance in living a kingdom lifestyle. The Torah is the Most High God's teachings and instructions and 613 principles. It's where the Creator speaks, Mother. And then we search the witnesses through the books of the prophets, the Nevi'ims, and the books of the writings, the Ketuvims, collectively the Torah. The Nevi'ims and the Ketuvims, or identified as the Tanakh, or as some refer to it, the Old Testament, which is the only book that Yahushua studied and referenced throughout the New Testament. Exodus chapter 23, verse 12. 6 days, you better come on, Holy Ghost, thou shalt do thy work. And on the seventh day, thou shalt rest, that thou ox and thou ass may rest, and the son of thou handmaid and the strangers may be refreshed. Come on now, it's time for a refreshing. Today we look to the word rest. Hebrews number 7:6-7:3. Shabbat, Sabbath, a primitive root, to repose, desist from exertion, cause to, let, make to, cease, celebrate, keep, Sabbath, leave, put away, make to rest, rid, steal, take away. Ooh, Lord, I want to enter into your rest. Take some stuff away. The Torah testifies. Exodus chapter 16, verse 23. And he said unto them, this is that which the Lord has said. Tomorrow is the rest of the holy Sabbath unto the Lord. Bake that which ye will bake today. Come on, April, and seethe that ye will seethe. And that which remaineth over, lay up for you to be kept until the morning. The prophets proclaim. Isaiah chapter 14, verse 3. And it shall come to pass in the day that the Lord shall give thee rest from thy sorrow and from thy fear and from the hard bondage wherein thou was made to serve. The writings bear witness. 1 Kings chapter 8, verse 56. Blessed be the Lord that has given rest unto his people, Israel. According to all that he promised, there has not failed one word of all his good promise, which he promised by the hand of Moses, his servant. We have completed the method style of study this morning, reviewing rest. First, we recognize the standard set in the Torah and 613 principles. Then we search the witnesses and the books of the prophets, the Nevi'ims, and the books of the writings, the Ketuvims. Collectively, the Torah, the Nevi'ims, and the Ketuvims, or identified as the Tanakh, which is the Old Testament's proper title, and is the only book that Yahushua studied and referenced throughout the New Testament. 5 a.m. prayer. You are to remember the Sabbath and to keep it holy. But stop profaning his word by teaching, spiritualizing, and keeping a man-made doctrine of a day of rest on day one Sunday. Or you will find yourself dying in the wilderness because you still have failed to keep his commandments alone. What you say? 5 a.m. prayer. We are to remember the Sabbath and to keep it holy. But stop profaning his word by teaching, spiritualizing, and keeping a man-made doctrine of a day of rest. Day one. Sunday, or you will find yourself dying in the wilderness because you have failed to keep his commandments alone. Exodus chapter 31, verse 15. 6 days may work be done, but in the seventh is the Sabbath of rest. Holy to the Lord, whosoever doeth any work in the Sabbath day, he shall surely be put to death. Oh my goodness. Oh Lord, did the word say that? Now you know you ain't gonna die a physical death, but you're probably dead because you can't get a word through or a prayer. Okay. Exodus chapter 31, verse 15. 6 days may work be done, but in the seventh is the Sabbath of rest. Holy, oh Lord, holy to the Most High God. Whosoever doeth any work in the Sabbath day, he shall surely be put to death. Oh Lord, Shalom Aleichem. Peace be unto you, 5 a.m. prayer community. Entering into his rest. Come on, Gina Tate. We made it, girl. We about to enter into his rest. Shalom Aleichem. Peace be unto you, 5 a.m. prayer community. Entering into his rest is not just about keeping the Sabbath, keeping of the Sabbath, but it is also entering into the promised land. What y'all say? Shalom! Don't have me start with these long prophets and writing again today. Woo, Lord! Shalom, Aleki. Peace be unto you, 5 a.m. prayer community. Entering into his rest is not just about the keeping of the Sabbath, but it is also entering into the promised land. If you cannot enter into his rest on a weekly by keeping the right day, you will also be refused entry into the promised land, a place of rest from the wilderness. What y'all say? Oh, Lord, I got to say that one more time. This got to be established in your hearing. Shema Israel. Hear, listen, and obey. Shalom Aleichem. Peace be unto you, 5 a.m. prayer community. Entering into his rest is not just about the keeping of the Sabbath, but it is also entering into the promised land. What'd you say? If you cannot enter into his rest on a weekly by keeping the right day, you will also be refused into the promised land, a place of rest from the wilderness. Hallelujah and glory to his name. Come on, Gina Tate. We're about to enter into his rest. Oh, Lord. So now, I sure won't stop. Are you ready? For the word of God. Most High God, 3 days in a row. The father of Abraham, the father of Isaac, oh Lord, the father of Jacob. Are you ready? Yes, Lord. For the word of God, the father of Abraham, the father of Isaac, the father of Jacob. This morning, we are coming out of the book of Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 4 in its entirety. Again, this morning, we are coming out of the book of Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 4 in its entirety, and it reads, let us therefore fear. See, you thought that was let not your heart be troubled. I sure wasn't going to say, I done messed that thing up. I'm gone with the law, prophets, and right. Oh, Lord, have mercy. Okay. Hebrews chapter 4 in its entirety, again, and it reads, let us therefore fear, lest a promise being left us of entering into his rest, any of you should seem to come short of it. Oh, let the scriptures explain the Sabbath day. I ain't got to keep talking about the Sabbath. The word became flesh and dwelt among us. Yahushua said, I am Lord of the Sabbath. Who knew it? Let us therefore fear, lest a promise being left us of entering into his rest, any of you should seem to come short of it. For unto us was the gospel preached, as well as unto them. But the word preached did not profit them, not being mixed with faith in them that heard it. For we which have believed to enter into rest, as he said, as I have sworn For he spake at a certain place of the seventh day on this wise. Come on, Hebrews chapter 4. For he spake at a certain place of the seventh day on the wise. And the Most High God did rest the seventh day from all his work. Oh, New Testament. Come on, y'all. That's what I'm talking about. And this, and in this place again, if they shall enter into my rest. Oh, this is good. Seeing therefore, it remaineth that some must enter therein, and they to whom it was first preached enter not in because of unbelief. Oh, I could worship on any day. Again, he limited a certain day. You better teach the word. Again, he limited a certain day, saying in David, today, after so long a time, as it is said, today, if ye will hear my voice. Ooh, Lord, harden not your heart, not the philosophy of men. Come on, Most High God. For if Yahushua had given them rest, then would he not afterward have spoken of another day like Sunday? Come on, Most High God. There remaineth, therefore, a rest to the people of the Most High God. For he that is entered into his rest, oh Lord, he also has ceased from his own works, as the Most High God did from his. Oh, Lord, no. Oh, Lord, hallelujah. And bless your name. Answer the church right now. Here go your answer, Miss Evelyn, to the church. Send the pastor that.
Oh, Lord.
For he that is entered into his rest, he also has ceased from his own works, as the Most High God did from his. Any questions? What day do you worship on? Oh, Lord, let us labor therefore to enter into that rest, lest any man fall after the same example of unbelief.
Oh, Lord. Oh, we could just worship on any day. That ain't what he said.
For the word of the Most High God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit, and of the joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. Neither is there any creature that is not manifest in his sight. But all things are naked and open unto the eyes of him with whom we have to do. Seeing then that we have a great high priest that is passed into heavens, Yeshua, the Son of the Most High God, let us hold fast our profession. For we have not a high priest which cannot be touched with the feelings of our infirmity, but was in all points tempted like as we are, yet without sin. Let us therefore come boldly
unto the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in a time of need. May the Most High God add a blessing to the reading and hearing of His most holy word. Are you kidding me? Have you read Hebrews chapter 4 before? We got so caught up in he like a two-edged sword that we forgot he entered into the rest on the Sabbath day. He stopped all his work like we should do because the Most High God ceased from his work on the sixth day and kept the Sabbath holy. He set that day apart from all the other days. That day is sanctified. It's pure holiness. It's communion with the Most High God. That's why it matters what day you serve him on. You better read Hebrews chapter 4 again. Send that to your pastor. Oh, Lord. Can't go to church now on Sunday anyway. You might as well discuss the Sabbath. Did you? I feel like the words just jumped off the page. Did y'all see that? Got you, Dr. J. You're letting out your heart. You like, that is not the word. I just want to read that over and over again. My soul is crying holy. April, have you read Hebrews chapter 4 like that before? Girl, what you say? He got a question for you. Whom do you say that is Mashiach in you? Woo! Come on, Holy Ghost! Whom do you say that he is? This question is personal. Yahushua is looking you in your face right now in the wilderness with a safer at home in place. And he's asking you a question. Whom do you say that I am? Mashiach in you. True identities are being revealed. Oh, it's time for a revelation. Come on, King Raynard. Have you ever read Hebrews chapter 4 like that? Because I haven't. I'm catching a revelation with you. True identities are being revealed. Beloved, 5 a.m. prayer.
Yeah.
Yahushua is restoring the truth that the body of Mashiach was robbed of centuries ago. You better come on, Most High. True identities are being revealed. Drop that air. I don't feel it. Beloved, 5 a.m. prayer. Yahushua is restoring the truth that the body of Mashiach was robbed of centuries ago. He is restoring the truth that for many years the canker worms have eaten and the palmer worms and the locust has devoured. He is revealing the truth of his word as a great spoil, as treasures recovered in battle. Come on, Most High God. The Most High God is doing, as it were, a new thing. The Most High God is doing, as it were, a new thing. Yet, it is not new, for there is nothing new under the sun. It just seems new to us, but it is simply the restoration of the tabernacle. live our lives as a tale that is told. That is everything that has happened before and seen in the Bible. It's our example of how it is going to happen in the last generation. Come on now. We are in the wilderness in a shutdown. Come on, Most High God. The Most High God is preparing a people and is purifying a company of people that will become his bride. Say it again, Dr. J. The Most High is preparing a people and is purifying a company of people that will become his bride. He is preparing them through their learning obedience. Yeah. He is preparing them through their learning obedience. The goal of which instruction is to be completed and made perfect in the love for Yahushua and for the brethren. The identity of the saints, the set apart ones of the Most High, the redeemed, the undefiled, is being made clear. Come on now. The identity of the saints, the set apart ones of the Most High, the redeemed, the undefiled, is being made clear. The identity of those that are redeemed, but who continue to be wicked in their action, is also coming into view. Yeah. Come on, Most High God. The identity of those that are redeemed, but who continue to be wicked in their action, is also coming to view. Uh-huh. As the fruit, their doings or works of the righteous begin to be seen. In the same way, the tares are being revealed, all in bundles, bound socially into denominations and congregations, ready to be burned. Come on, Most High God. Let us notice the following passages and note how the Most High identifies the ones that are his people, his saints. Here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that keep the commandments of the Most High God and the faith of Yahushua. Revelations chapter 14, verse 12. Blessed are they that do his commandments, that they may have right to the tree of life, and may enter in through the gates into the city. Revelations chapter 22, verse 14. So in these verses, who the saints really are and how one gains right to the tree of life. Yahushua himself, and how one gains entry into the city of the king. Note carefully that in the verse, there is no believing mentioned. What you say? Notice in the verse, there is no believing mentioned. As we have understood the word believe in these verses, there is simply doing, that is, allowing Mashiach in you to bring about the doing of obedience to his word, which is the biblical definition of believing.
Yeah.
Notice that obedience to the commandments of the Most High is really a summary definition of the word believe. Say that again, Dr. J. Notice that obedience to the commandments of the Most High is really a summary definition of the word believe.
Yeah.
The reader is encouraged to do a brief study of Abraham and what the Most High said about him and why the Most High credited him with righteousness. The greatest tragedy of this generation is the teaching of the traditions, doctrines, and commandments of men in the place of scriptures. One result of this replacement is that one beautiful truth of the Most High's word is taken to the exclusion of another, causing many to try to force the pieces of the puzzle together. Even when some pieces do not quite fit the way men's doctrines say they are supposed to fit. Hence, we have multitude of splintered beliefs and divisions created among men, divided into congregations that are open only to what lies within the comfort zone of their own understanding, yet closed-minded to any light from the spirit of the truth that does not fit what they already understand. Come on, Most High God! It is in this way that the commandment of men, true, turn men away from being doers of the truth, according to Titus chapter 1, verse 14. This sounds as if it were a description of the religious leader of Yahushua day. But sadly, it portrays our day too. Oh, this the letters that's going out to the church this morning. Send this video. My commandments, beloved, 5 a.m. prayer. When Yahushua said, if ye love me, keep my commandments. In John chapter 14, verse 15. What was he telling us? What was he telling us? Today, almost all the Bible schools and theological seminaries and their pastor graduates are teaching that the commandments of Yahushua are found only in the New Testament, from Matthew through Revelation. Those who know who Yahushua truly is, however, understand that my commandments appear from the beginning, from the book of Genesis. Those who say that Yahushua's commandments are only in the New Testament are testifying that they do not know who Yahushua truly is. When Yahushua returns, he will say to many pastors and leaders who did not truly know him, and to their followers, I never knew you. You that work iniquity. It is thus to our advantage to test everything against the scriptures alone. What you say? It is thus to our advantage to test everything against the scriptures alone, not what man says. Beloved, notice the following verse. In flaming fire, taking vengeance on them that know not the Most High God, and that obey not the gospel of our Lord Yahushua HaMashiach. Oh, that's in the New Testament, Pastor. 2 Thessalonians chapter 1, verse 8. We have long thought that this passage is talking about the heathens, the pagans, the wicked. those that have never come to Yahushua. Unfortunately, there are vast multitudes, great multitudes of New Testament believers today that are in this category. They have come to Yahushua, have received of his wonderful mercy and grace of redemption and forgiveness by his precious blood, but are still, in the valley of decisions between two mountains, half between two opinions. As babes, however, the Most High offers us great mercy as he gently leads those who desire to follow him and learn from him. What you say? Mm-hmm. As more mature believers, the Most High is urging us to get off the fence. That's what I'm talking about. As more mature believers, the Most High is urging us to get off the fence. As believers, their yoke of bondage have been initially broken. The spirit of life has set them free from the law of sin and death. But they have not entered into a new yoke bondage of love as a voluntary bond slave to a new master in obedience to his will and his word. Thus many shall not be brought up into the heights of Zion, the city of the king, and will not be allowed to know him unless they show by their obedience they know who Yahushua really is. And they begin to walk in obedience to all his sayings. This process of coming to know him by our obedience to his word, as seen in 2 Thessalonians chapter 1 verse 8, is what constitutes believing in Yahushua. We have seen that the sayings of Yahushua are made up of both the New Testament sayings of Yahushua and the Old Testament sayings of Yahushua, which are also Yahushua's saying. The great significance can now come into view. Can you see them now? The great significance can now come into view. We recall that the Most High wrote the Ten Commandments with the finger of the Most High onto the stone tablets. These are the Most High sayings and his words. Notice also that Yahushua wielded the finger of the Most High when he cast out devils. There is a vast amount of New Testament scriptures that reveals the connection between loving Yahushua and keeping the commandments of Yahushua, and also remarkably keeping the commandments of the Most High. Yeah. Many today have not made the connection. I'm going to say that again. Many today have not made the connection or have not realized that keeping the commandments of the Most High constitutes knowing who Yahushua is and loving Yahushua, and also defines how we show love for the brethren. According to 1 John chapter 5. Verse 2 and 3, stealing your inheritance. What you say? Stealing your inheritance. Some believers today say they keep the Ten Commandments. Others say they are only for the Jews, not Gentiles. Still, others say that they are not for New Testament saints, but are legalism and bondage. A few today keep and observe the feast of the Most High. Many today would say they love the Most High and desire to keep his word. However, they have been taught that the second and fourth commandment are not for us. The meaning of these commandments, as much of scripture, have been spiritualized by well-meaning pastors and teachers to mean something different, so as not to apply the New Testament saints. So as not to apply to the New Testament saints. Many pastors and teachers think that we are not able to search the scriptures for ourselves. To see what it really says in the spiritualized version of a truth, which is a particular spin put on the truth, sounds very close to what scriptures actually say. The result is that some of the pastors and spiritual leaders are stealing the inheritance of their many followers. We must read the scriptures for ourselves and find the truth. How are we to know the truth? Just what does it mean to spiritualize scripture? Let us find out as we make up an example of what it means to spiritualize scripture. Let us say that we read the following verse, "Thou shall not kill," according to Exodus chapter 20, verse 13. We immediately say, this must be a New Testament saint, because Yahushua told us that we are not to hate our brother. And murder is the same as hating our brother. The explanation now becomes my definition of what the verse passage says. I could then conclude that under the spiritualized meaning of this verse, it is all right to literally kill someone, but not hate them, which is the spiritualized equivalent. By this example, we can see that spiritualizing the meaning, the plain common sense meaning, is discarded in favor of a spiritualized meaning or explanation. The next example is a little less stretch of truth, and it's actually believable to many believers of this generation. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Exodus chapter 20, verse 14. Reading this verse, one might think, for New Testament believers, adultery in the Most High's eyes is the equivalent of worshiping an idol or another god. If one were to spiritualize this verse in Exodus, one may conclude that it must be okay to commit literal adultery, but it's not okay to commit idolatry, which is a spiritualized adultery. How utterly absurd that would be. Yet the same example of this reasoning occurs as a codified standard in the vast realm of the religious world today. Let us see why.
Well, we will now look at a classic example of spiritualizing scripture, resulting in a doctrine that most pastors and spiritual leaders today have bought into, bringing great loss to the body of Mashiach as a lack of fullness of the life of Mashiach in us. Mm-hmm. Notice, come on, Most High God, the following passage. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy.
Yeah.
Set apart as special. 6 days thou shalt labor. 6 days shall thou labor and do all thy work. But the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord, the Most High God. In it thou shalt not do any work. Thou, nor thy son, nor thy daughter, thou maidservant, thou maidservant, nor thy cattle, nor the strangers that is within thy gates. For in 6 days the Lord made the heavens and the earth, the sea, and all that is in them, and rested the seventh day. Wherefore the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and hallowed it. Exodus chapter 20, verse 8 through 11. The precious believing ones today have been taught by their leaders a spiritualized understanding of the Most High Sabbath day. Believers worldwide have been taught the decrees of Rome regarding this passage, stating that for New Testament believers, the Sabbath of the Most High speak only of two spiritualized meaning and are not to be kept literally. Oh, come on now, Holy Ghost. Teach this thing today. Two separate spiritualized explanations of this passage are generally given. First, it is spiritualized by some who see this as merely an explanation for a future event. This man-made explanation describes the future millennium kingdom, which is actually a true prophetic picture of what the seventh day portrayed, but only in a prophetic sense of fulfillment. Along with this explanation, believers are told they are not to keep this commandment in a literal sense, but to keep it instead the New Testament Sabbath, which is a man-made Sabbath decreed by Rome. Second, the teaching of the Sabbath day is taught by many as spiritualized explanation for the present. Many believers today have been taught a spiritualized Sabbath rest, but not of the literal keeping of the Sabbath day. Mm-hmm. One man-made explanation goes on to say that to keep the Sabbath is to enter into a state of rest, which one supposedly enter into when one's rest moment by moment in Father's grace in the finished work of Yahushua. Along with this explanation, believers are told that they are not to keep the Sabbath day in a literal sense, but are to keep only the New Testament Sabbath, the man-made Sabbath decreed by Rome. Come on, Most High.
Yeah.
The pastors and leaders that say things are not seeking the Most High. The pastors and leaders that say such things are not seeking the Most High. And are not studying the scripture. 11 has been spiritualized to a point that is literal meaning has been made of no effect in the lives of many believers, one who truly loved the Most High. The body of Mashiach in this generation has been taught that a man-made notion of the Lord's Day has replaced the Sabbath day of the Ten Commandments.
Yes.
Using the same line of reasoning, the believers today have been taught also that idolatry is not so important in the lives of the blood-bought and forgiven believers. You better see 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 14. You better read 1 John chapter 5, verse 21. You better read Revelation chapter 2, verse 14. Drop down to verse 20. We shall examine these ideas a little later against the light of the scripture, scrambling to plug in the holes in their theology. Come on, Most High God. Man-made theologians got you serving the wrong God. Come on, Most High God. Scrambling to plug in the holes in their theology. Many theologians have sprung further webs of deception to describe the closely related teaching of enter into his rest. So as we saw in the scriptures, some have taught that the Sabbath day is only symbolic of the seventh millennium, the true Sabbath of the Most High. And the weekly Sabbath was only a shadow of that Sabbath to come. This is half truth and half lie. Say it again. This is half truth and half lie. Beloved, 5 a.m. prayer.
Yeah.
Many Bible teachers today are teaching that the weekly Sabbath is only a spiritual Sabbath and that the New Testament saints rest in the finished work of Yahushua, and that the New Testament believers no longer has to work in one's own effort to be obedient, to be found righteous. Another half truth and a half lie. Scripture tells us, however, that we must labor, work, extend great effort to enter into the same rest Abba entered, according to Hebrews chapter 4, verse 10 and 11. Perhaps the great effort is required in order to defeat the great many man-made doctrines that would lead us astray. It is important for the bride company to note that both of these popular teachings are not 100% error, but express a mixture of truth and error. The truth aspect is in regard to both a future and a present spiritual aspect of the 7-day Sabbath of the Most High. The error comes by ignoring the literal aspect, just as our examples of murder and adultery prove.
Yeah.
Moreover, in expressing the exclusiveness of spiritual aspect of the 7-day Sabbath of the Most High, the popular teachings ignore the fact that there are 7 additional feasts of the Most High that he calls my Sabbath, for a total of 8. Of the Most High Sabbath. Let us now see why this issue of the Most High Sabbath is an important issue for the bride. Come on, Miko. Let us now see why this issue of the Most High Sabbath is an important issue for the bride. Laboring
to enter his rest. Mm-hmm. What you say? Mm-hmm. Laboring to enter his rest. We will now note the great importance of the Most High Sabbath, which have been hidden from the body of Mashiach, who have been robbed and stolen from and spoiled from a battle by an enemy that does not want to see Yahushua's people enter into their inheritance.
My Lord.
Let's notice the following passage. 40 years long was I grieved with this generation and said, it is a people that do err, go astray in their hearts, and they have not known my ways, unto whom I swear in my wrath that they should not enter into my rest. According to Psalms chapter 95, verse 10 and 11, let us labor, therefore, to enter into that rest, lest any man fall after the same example of unbelief. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 11. Scripture tells us that although Israel was redeemed from Egypt by the blood of the Lamb, the original generations were refused entry into the promised land, all except Joshua and Caleb. So in the passage in Psalms chapter 95, verse 10 and 11, we see the Most High tells us that they were not allowed to enter into his rest, showing us that entering his rest is a picture of entering into the promised land. So in Hebrews chapter 4, verse 11, it warns us that we too must labor to enter his rest, lest we too be refused entry into the promised land. In the same example as the Israelites, as the context indicates, since this is such an important example for us, taking up two chapters in the book of Hebrews, we would do well to find out exactly what it means to enter his rest and what could prevent us from entering his rest. For a clue to what this means, let us look at the passage again. This time, along with its companion, the previous passage. Mm-hmm. For he that is entered into his rest, he also has ceased from his own work. You gotta come on, scripture. Let the scripture speak. Line upon line, precept upon precept. I'm going to let the word teach you, because you've been taught by man for too long. Everything we do on 5 a.m. prayer, we prove it by the scriptures.
My Lord.
For he that is entered into his rest, he also has ceased from his own works, as the Most High God did from his. Let us labor, therefore, to enter into that rest, lest any man fall after the same example of unbelief. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 10 and 11. So in this passage, Yahushua tells us we must enter into his rest by ceasing from our own work, just as the Most High ceased from his work.
Yeah.
What is the simple and plain meaning of this passage? Let's look at some possibilities of what it means. First, let's ask, how did the Most High rest from his work. Come on, pastor. Come on, theologians. Come on, doctor so-and-so. I'm talking to you this morning.
Yes.
First, let's ask, how did the Most High rest from his work? If we can find how the Most High rested from his works, perhaps we too could do the same as we are told to do. Let's look into this. So how did the Most High rest from his work?
Yeah.
Come on, Most High God. Did the Most High decide to postpone his rest until the future millennium Sabbath? The great day of Jubilee? No. But this is one explanation given by theologians of what we are to do. Did the Most High trust in the precious blood of Yahushua that was shed for remission of sin in order to allow the Most High to rest in Yahushua, thus allowing the Most High to rest in the grace of forgiveness of the Most High's own sins, so that Yah, the Most High, might be made righteous, so that the Most High would no longer struggle under a consciousness of sin? That's an explanation. That explanation is one of several given to us by theologians and seminaries and their blind graduates. Come on, Most High God. Yeah. Expose the truth. It's about time you walk up into the church and turn over the tables.
Yeah.
That explanation is one of several given to us by theologian seminaries and their blind graduates. Most of the pastors and leaders of this generation, as an explanation of how they say we are to enter into his rest. How utterly absurd can the doctrines of men become when held against the blinding light and strong meat of the Most High's precious word? Say that again. Oh, Lord. How utterly obscured can the doctrine of man become when held against the blinding light and the strong meat of the Most High God's word? Where you at now? Did the Most High rest in either of the two ways given in these examples? How did the Most High rest from his work? Come on, Erica. How did the Most High rest from his work? Let's see what scripture tells us. Come on, Miko. Let's see what scripture tells us.
Yeah.
And on the seventh day, the Most High God ended his work, which he had made, and he rested on the seventh day from all his work, which he had made. And the Most High God blessed the seventh day and sanctified it, because in it he had rested from all his work, which the Most High God created and made. Genesis chapter 2, verse 2 and 3. We see the answer very clearly in Genesis chapter 2, verse 2 and 3. The Most High simply ceased his work and rested on a literal seventh day. What you say? We see from the scripture, according to Genesis chapter 2, verse 2 and 3, the Most High simply ceased from his work and rested on a literal 7 day. Yes. We must stop spiritualizing scripture. I'm going to say it again. We must stop spiritualizing scripture and return to the clear and simple meaning of scripture and return to the simplicity and rest that is found only in the obedience to Mashiach Yahushua according to the scriptures. It is plain to see that we enter into his rest in our literal obedience to the fourth commandment of resting from all literal work on a literal 7 day, just as the Most High rested from his work.
Yeah.
What we do is simply a matter of whether we are yoked with Yahushua. Say it again. What we do is simply a matter of whether we are yoked to Yahushua or not. If we are yoked to him, we work when he works and we rest when he rests. Yeah. Come on, Most High God. If we are yoked to him, we work when he works and we rest when he rests. If Yahushua rested on the 7 day, then we are supposed to do the same. The pattern for us is in the Gospels, yeah, as well as the epistles, as a testimony to what Yahushua and the Talmudim's disciples did on the Sabbath day, as well as on the other feast days of the Most High Sabbath. If we can say, as the Apostle Paul did, Mashiach liveth in me, then let us ask ourselves these questions. Are we following? Are we allowing Mashiach to live in us in all his fullness as revealed in the pages of the New Testament?
Yeah.
Are we preventing Mashiach, who lives within our bodies, from observing the feast of his Father in obedience to the scriptures? Do we say that Mashiach lives within us, within our bodies, yet continue to refuse to allow him in us to walk in obedience to the scriptures simply because the teachings we have received? Ooh. Beloved, 5 a.m. prayer. The New Testament is full of warnings, exhortations, and teachings of simple, literal obedience to the Most High's commandments and to all his judgments, orders, precepts. The scriptures tells us of the consequences of doing so and of not doing so.
Ah.
Even though under the new covenant, when given a choice, according to Matthew chapter 11, verse 29, and they are voluntarily. There are many man-made ideas commonly taught today, saying that the Old Testament commandments are not for New Covenant believers. These ideas are not true. They have no foundation in the scriptures whatsoever, and they contradict both the Old and New Testament scriptures.
Yes.
Amen, 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 and amen. I dare you to enter into his rest and to understand what that means. I'm going to say it again. There are many man-made ideas commonly taught today saying that the Old Testament commandments are not for New Covenant believers. These ideas are not true. They have no foundation in scripture whatsoever, and they contradict
Respond out of ourselves. We teach why the Sabbath is on the seventh day, and that's when you worship the Most High God. The Spirit taught that thing this morning. There is no wiggle room. Y'all can keep showing up on Sunday if you want to. But that message right there, there is no wiggle room. You shall know the truth. And the truth shall make you free. I'm so glad I don't respond out of myself. We seek the scriptures. Not trying to get in no battle with no pastors or anybody else. I'm going to let the word speak. Line upon line, precept upon precept. Come for us again. We got a whole book. From Genesis to Revelations. Bring it. I'm going to let the word speak. So, whom do you say that he is? Because right now he's saying you don't even know him. I never knew you. Depart from me, ye who work iniquity. Hallelujah. This is a way to enter into his rest. Oh my goodness.
If the Most High God be for me, I don't know why y'all keep coming.
Then who can be against me? If the Most High God be for me, then who can be against me? Thank you, Most High. Just keep teaching. Mm-hmm. Just keep teaching. That's all you got to do. Keep teaching. Wow. This is amazing. Because this question was asked on the day before yesterday. And this word was already prepared for today.
So I didn't have to go seek this out. I was like, whoa, what you say?
Oh, I'll prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemies. This word was already prepared. I'm over here right now running and screaming inside my soul. He did this. I didn't do this. He did this. I keep telling y'all, I don't look at these words before I teach it. The Holy Spirit leads me and I just teach it. And it's like, boom! Are you kidding me? To be led by the Spirit like that? Girl, no. If the Most High God be for you, then who can be against you? Just keep teaching his word. We ain't got to battle with nobody. We ain't got to fight with nobody. Just keep teaching. Show them in the scripture. Because their problem is they got their philosophy. They went to theology school. You know, I went to theology school, got a PhD. I didn't go to seminary. I went to the cemetery because that was a dead word. That wasn't the word of the Most High God. So I graduated from the cemetery too. They got the theologians, you know, the doctrines of men, what they believe. They philosophize. I'm sorry. That ain't what the scripture says. So I'm going to walk in what the scripture says. So that's where your revelation is at. In the scriptures, not in you. Okay. Whew. I'm going to enter into his rest. This is going to be an awesome El Shabbat dinner. Shabbat Shalom. Hey, Shabbat Shalom. I think I might need me some challah bread today, April. I'm going to need me some challah at your girl. Thank you, Most High God. So good. So get to the Blogspot, get to Facebook, get to YouTube. Rest in his holy Sabbath day. Hallelujah. It will encourage you. Hallelujah. I love you, love you, love you. Oh, I love you. Bye now. So good. So good.